Good morning. I'm Dr. To, MP for Nampa. This morning, I just want to mention something about the ruling by the speaker about the questions and the debate pertaining to the suit filed by the Department of Justice America being sub judice. For the questions that were submitted by me, actually five were related to the case filed by Department of Justice of United States of America. And there were many other questions filed by other MPs as well, especially by the opposition. On Monday last week, 17th of October 2016, the book with all the answers given back to me on the oral questions they were answered. Actually, there were seven questions in relation to the Department of Justice. I had three questions alone, and there are four other questions by Kelana Jaya, Pematang Pau, Payang Baru, and Ladang. But they were all given a standard answer. It doesn't matter what questions we ask, the answer was the Kementerian tidak dapat mengemukakan jawapan kepada soalan ini adalah masih dalam pertimbangan mahkamah (bracket sub judice) sebagaimana yang telah diputuskan oleh YP yang dipertua Dewan Rakyat pada 17 hari bulan Oktober 2016. However, if you look at the questions, some of them were not actually sub judice in nature. Question 30 by me was to ask whether the Prime Minister to state whether he's read the case filed by the Department of Justice to seize $1 billion worth of assets that was supposedly taken away from 1NDB. And also to ask him whether he agreed or he found anything that was untrue in the case filed by the Department of Justice. And also the other questions were mainly related to who was Malaysian officer number one. Also, whether he agreed with his minister, Datuk Abdul Rahman Dahlan, when he gave the interview in UK, that Prime Minister himself was MO1, whether he agreed to it. And the last thing is whether Malaysian government is going to help the investigations by the DOJ into the ongoing saga with 1NDB. All these are actually of no relations to the judgment going to be passed by the judge in US. Because all this just asks whether he read the case filed by the DOJ, whether Malaysian government is going to help to clear the names of those implicated in the case filed by the DOJ. Of course, we have a lot of interest in this case, as supposedly $4 billion are stolen from 1NDB. And the very suspicious thing is all these questions were asked on the 17th of October. That was before the question was submitted before 17th of October, and the speaker only made the ruling on Monday itself. But the answers were all standard and given to the seven questions asked on that day. So obviously, the government didn't want to answer the questions. And obviously, they knew the speaker was going to make the ruling to say the questions on the case that is sub judice cannot be answered. But that one, flies in the face of common sense. Just three other countries, including Singapore, UK and Switzerland, are looking into the case and actively reporting on it. When Malaysia has no case filed in the court, it's not allowed to ask questions or debate on it. It doesn't make sense. Just every week you can hear reports coming from Switzerland, UK or Singapore about what they are going to do into all the money laundering involving people and banks involved and implicated in this multi-billion scandal. So all I can say is it is very disappointing the speaker had used the word sub judice, even though the question asked were not sub judice in nature. We hope the speaker would not would reveal his decision and allow the Malaysian public to be better informed, as we are very much involved. If we can debate the questions on the 1MDB and the DOJ suit better, it will help us to clear the air and especially those implicated in the scandal. Thank you. There are 7 questions on Monday alone, and they were all given the standard answer, and it's very unsatisfactory.